about 2,500 years ago. The Tao lecturing platform at Mount Zhongnan was enveloped in mist and exceptionally quiet. However, beyond the mountain was a chaotic world, tormented by violence. Over a span of some 300 years, from 770 BC, when the Eastern Zhou Dynasty was founded, to the spring and autumn period in 476 BC, numerous wars occurred. More than 100 vassal states perished in succession, and the people were reduced to utter misery.
Lao师, 天下纷乱不堪, 皆因战事而起, 那么如何才能消除战争呢?
战争, 是由人的私欲所来, 没有过度的私欲, 才能没有了战争。
老师, 您是如何看待战争?
兵者, 不祥之气也, 不得已用之。
Laozi didn't blindly oppose war. He stressed the need of a just war. If there is a war, there must be a way to end it. How to win a war? He offered some direction on this.
以政治国, 以其用兵, 以无事, 取天下。
Many found it hard to understand what Laozi was saying. However, a military strategist in the same period explained war in a very compelling way. All warfare is based on deception, he said. The theory is believed to have been used in all later period wars. This idea came from Sun Tzu, known as the ultimate military strategist. In 506 BC, troops of the state of Wu captured Yengdu, the capital of the state of Chu. Wu Zexu and Sun Tzu were Wu army commanders. Their troops numbered 60,000. They deceived the enemy by marching in a 1,000-mile circle, catching the enemy by surprise. In 5 battles, they defeated more than 200,000 Chu troops. Suddenly, the 300-year-old Chu state faced extinction. Sun Tzu thus assisted the Wu state to defeat the Chu state with his military strategies. His book, The Art of War, contains a comprehensive description of his war strategies that have been studied and implemented by successive generations all the way to the present time. The Art of War is a military work, but also a philosophical treatise imbued with Taoist thought. Across 13 chapters, it depicts a world threatened by repeated wars. It delineates that yin and yang undergo mutual transformation, which represents the dialectical philosophy of Taoism.
孙子兵法同样开宗明义说：“应者国之大事，使生之地，存亡之道不可不察。”孙子以兵为国之大事，其出发点就是圣战。他的非礼不动，非德不用，非为不战，主不可弄而兴师，将不可怨而自战，充分体现了他的圣战思想。这一点可以说与老子异曲同工。
Why were the ideas of Laozi and Sun Tzu so close? Did Laozi ever offer suggestions to Sun Tzu in this regard? The two lived in the same era, but there is no evidence they ever had a discussion on the subject. In the pre-Qin era, with so many scholars, it's not in the least strange that these two men would share some common thoughts and philosophies. When Tao Te Ching spread from Mount Zhongnan to other parts of China, wars among the vassal states didn't fade away as envisioned by Laozi, but instead became more frequent and tragic. Laozi's strategy, weapons of war may be used with crafty dexterity, found vivid expression in these conflicts. In 262 BC, the Qin state and the Zhao state fought ferociously at Chongping in the state of Han. Both were the most powerful of the seven states. 1 million Qin and Zhao troops fought numerous bloody battles in an attempt to vanquish the other. In the beginning of the war, the Qin troops gained the upper hand. Led by a very experienced general, Lian Po, the Zhao troops built fortresses to wait for chances to defeat the Qin. The Qin army suffered heavy losses, but had no way to turn the tide. Zhao troops followed this path for 3 years. Both states were close to financial ruin. They tried to fight a quick battle to end the conflict. According to Laozi's philosophy of warfare, the general must try his best to employ certain schemes and strategies to win the war on an ever-changing battlefield. The king of Qin state and his subjects plotted a breakthrough. They spread a rumor that the Qin feared General Zhao Ku due to his fierceness. The Zhao king was duped by this and replaced General Lian Po with Zhao Ku, who was actually a greenhorn in war. At the same time, the Qin king gave Bai Qi, Lord of the Martial Peace, command of an army of some 600,000 troops in the fight against the Zhao. All of this was able to take place without the Zhao knowing because the Qin King decreed he'd behead anyone who leaked the news. Zhao Ko was inexperienced in war. He changed Lian Po's defensive strategy and organized a life and death fight. This proved a fatal mistake. Without knowing the enemy's situation, a commander shouldn't rush to attack, which was one of Lao Zha's military strategies.
轻率会丧失根本，急躁会失去主宰。统帅最大的灾祸就是轻敌呀。When
Zhao Ko staged an all-out attack on Qin troops, General Bai Qi saw it as the dawn of victory on the eastern horizon.
Lao Shi, how is Ru?
Ru, the way Rou. Tianxia Zhi Zhi Rou, Chi Cheng Yu, Tianxia Zhi Zhi Jian.
Na Rou, Rou He Neng Ke Jian Na?
Ni Wo, Zuo Xia Zhi Shi, Qian Gou Wan He, Quan Ping, Shang Shang Liu Shui Zhi Li. 天下莫柔弱于水，而攻坚强者莫之能陷。老子的一个重要军事论断就是柔弱胜刚强，要实现柔胜刚、弱胜强，是需要智慧和力量的完美结合。
General Bai Qi knew the Zhao army was powerful, but that its general was inexperienced. So Bai Qi decided to show weakness and avoid a direct confrontation with the Zhao army in an attempt to win the war with minimal loss.
Bai Qi 预料到赵括初来乍到，对秦军的战斗力心中没底，一定会对秦军发动试探性进攻。他利用赵括刚好轻敌的弱点，蓄意展开歼灭赵军的部署。
In August 260 BC, Zhao Ko launched a life-and-death attack. After a slight confrontation, the Qin troops began to retreat. Zhao Ko ordered a pursuit. When the Zhao troops made their way to where the Qin army was, they met stubborn resistance.
用诱敌之计，佯败而走，同时安排两股兵马，25,000人，以抄赵军后路，构筑坚固营垒，以抵御赵军的进攻。用5,000轻骑插入赵军营垒，将赵军切成两段，并派兵断其粮道。
According to Lao Zha's military theory of the soft overcoming the hard, Qin General Bai Qi retreated for the sake of advancing. He struck only after being struck. The Zhao army was besieged for 46 days. When they ran out of food, the troops faced almost certain death. Zhao Ko was in a quandary. He personally led the elite troops to try and force a way out, but was killed by a Jin arrow. All of his 400,000 troops were starving and faced imminent death. They eventually surrendered to the Qin army. After this battle, the six states east of Shanhai Pass were unable to resist Qin domination.
老师，为什么您说善于用兵的人，行军没有队列，奋起时没有挥臂，手中没有武器，交战没有敌人呢？
银溪，没有，就是空。因为空，方才可以因势利导，腾挪转移，因敌之变而变。
好一个变字，万千气象，守于其表，藏于其中，顺时而动。
其实守与藏，胜过争与戮。争天下，在智，不在勇；在隐，不在显呐。善于当统帅的人，从不炫耀武力；善于作战的人，从不逞一时怒气。善于战胜敌人的人，从不轻易与敌人交战。
Laozi believed that war is the greatest sorrow and the root of the world's misery. The wisest commanders should be good at reining in their ambition and desires, and eventually win the way without fighting. He believed that real heroes are those who can avoid wars. In the early 13th century, the Mongol Empire began to rise. Its cavalry slaughtered people here and there, plunging Asia into a time of terror. Qiu Chuji was the fifth teacher of the Chuanzhen school of Taoism. In the early spring of 1220, Teacher Qiu and some of his disciples were trekking in an area north of the Gobi Desert. Qiu and his disciples were summoned by Genghis Khan, the Mongol leader. Qiu didn't know about the Khan, and he worried about their safety. Qiu was sorry to see the suffering of the people while on his journey. To end the Mongol reign of terror, the 70-year-old Taoist chief was determined to meet and try and persuade Genghis Khan to end the violence. This was a legendary meeting. Some 800 years ago, Qiu Chuji lectured on Taoism at Genghis Khan's tent out on the grassland of Central Asia. No records are available regarding what he said to the Khan, but at least history offers an answer. In 1223, Genghis Khan began to retreat from Central Asia. Also in 1223, he ordered an end to the harassment of various states in the Central Plains. People finally had the time to recuperate. In the ensuing decade, no major battles were fought along the Yellow River. Taoist teacher Qiu Juji followed the spirit of Laozi in speaking with the warlord. Facing Genghis Khan, the words of Laozi weighed heavily on his mind.
Bing zhe bu xiang zhi qi, bu de yi er yong zhi, tian dan wei shang. Wei you bu zheng, tian xia cai mo.
Laozi's preaching, being calm, reflected his desire for peace. Before he went to meet with Genghis Khan, teacher Qiu Juji expressed his thoughts in a poem. I still miss Shandong after traveling this long. I am going to see the emperor to try and bring about peace.